Video, we are going to talk about how biological components are delivered into cells, focusing on the gene editing tool CRISPR-Cas9. But first, it's worth noting that all living systems use a conserved process that is known as the Central Dogma to produce the functional units of life. The three main components of the Central Dogma are DNA, RNA, and protein.
These biomolecules are maintained through processes known as DNA replication, transcription, which converts DNA into RNA, and translation, which converts RNA into protein. In eukaryotic cells, DNA is localized in the nucleus, while RNA and protein is most often found in the cytoplasm.
To deliver anything into cells, we have to remember that eukaryotic cells are surrounded by a cell membrane that is designed to keep most things out.
In this video, we're going to discuss various techniques to overcome the obstacle of getting DNA, RNA, and protein into cells.
So why do we even want to deliver outside molecules into cells?
Well, a scientist may want to introduce DNA, RNA, or protein in order to investigate a biological process or to treat disease. To investigate a biological process, for example, a scientist may want to introduce a fluorescent protein in order to track a specific cell. To treat disease, a researcher may either introduce a functional copy of the faulty gene or deliver a genome editing agent like CRISPR-Cas9 to correct the faulty sequence.
The main methods we'll discuss today by which DNA, RNA, or protein can be delivered into a eukaryotic cell are either chemical, physical, or viral based.
And these techniques are typically used to either express a gene or to inhibit gene expression. And in this video, we'll relate our various techniques to the delivery of the genome editing agent CRISPR-Cas9.
Physical delivery relies on a temporary destabilization of the cell membrane to enable DNA, RNA, or protein to enter. Methods of physical delivery are amazingly diverse. Scientists can electrocute cells, inject cells, or even squeeze cells. The most commonly used method is electroporation. During this procedure, a voltage is applied and an electrical current passes through the cells. This leads to the formation of holes in the cell membrane through which nucleic acids or protein are then able to enter the cell.
For the electroporation of CRISPR-Cas9, this is typically done in one of two ways. First, a researcher may electroporate a Cas9 guide RNA complex directly into the cell, which is then immediately able to carry out the gene editing process. For homology-directed repair, a researcher would also introduce the HDR template. The second method is to electroporate plasmids, which either contain the Cas9 molecule, the guide RNA, or, where relevant, the homology-directed template. Once inside the cell, these plasmids are then transcribed into RNA. The RNA for Cas9 is translated into the protein, which is then able to carry out the gene editing process.
Chemical delivery allows the introduction of outside nucleic acids into the cell using chemicals. These methods can be used to introduce DNA and RNA, but typically not protein. Chemical transfections can be transient, meaning that the introduced nucleic acid is only temporarily present inside the cell, or stable, meaning that the DNA has integrated into the genome and will be expressed indefinitely.
The most commonly used method for chemical transfection is based on a system that uses cationic lipids. Cationic lipids are positively charged and are used to deliver DNA or RNA into cells. Because they are positively charged, these cationic lipids can form a complex with the negatively charged DNA. And because the cell is made up of a membrane, these DNA lipid complexes can then enter the cell, leading to the nucleic acid being taken up and eventually expressed.
Delivery of genetic information by viral-based methods uses a virus's natural ability to infect a cell and enter the nucleus.
In nature, a virus will infect the host and piggyback on the cellular machinery in order to replicate and spread through a population. For a researcher to use viruses as a tool, however, we have figured out two main things. One, how to make the virus safe. This is done by separating the most important components of the virus into separate units such that the virus can no longer replicate by itself in cell culture or in an animal. And two, researchers have figured out how to alter the viral genome in order to modify it with a specific gene of interest.
Using a viral-based method enables the delivery genes into cell types that can be very difficult to modify by physical or chemical methods.
And in the case of CRISPR-Cas9, the virus is modified to express both the guide RNA and the Cas9 molecule. Once the virus infects the cell, it is then able to express these two components to produce a functional CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing system.
This approach is being developed to one day potentially treat many different diseases.
We hope you enjoyed this video.
And thanks for connecting with LabXchange.